Well, there's this stuff. afternoon. So glad you're here. My name is Lisa Graham. I'm the director of choral music here at Wellesley College, and we warmly welcome you to A December to Remember. This is our holiday concert this year, and our hearts are full to be able to sing in person our annual Christmas concert this year. Not the vespers that we are traditionally used to, but we're able to share our joy, our cheer, our moments of silence together through music in this wonderful event today, which we have the choir and the chamber singers and so many wonderful musicians that have contributed to our preparation for this concert. So many thanks, especially to you for coming. I hope you enjoy this afternoon of music and some laughs, I hope, and some readings and poems, and that this will kick off your holiday spirit. O come, all ye faithful.
The wondrous story. The world was born, but Christ is born. to change our sadness into glory. Sing, earthlings, sing. Tonight a king hath come from heaven's high throne to bless us. The outstretched hand o'er the land is raised in pity to caress us. Come at his call, be joyful all, away with mourning and with sadness. The heavenly choir, with holy fire, their voices raise in songs of gladness.
Thank you. sodden moss sinks underfoot when we cross half-frozen bays and walk through birch groves, wandering in uneven circles that widen into darkness. Through the minds and bodies of men and animals trapped in last year's snow, no, trapped from the beginning. Emptiness all around us, ice collecting on our pale faces. I can hear you singing on the run, an unknown melody. I can't make out the words. Clouds of breath freeze on your fur collar, eyes open wide as we trudge through silence and weakening starlight, through the fevered babble of the children exiled to distant camps. Insects curling up under bark, December or June, no difference. Ashes blanket the ground as far as you can see. Damp wool of shirts, we wade through the fog, rolling in from the hills, oozing into our lungs. Hills where there must be flowers, about to bloom under a woman's eyelids, who dreams of dark faces hardening into granite. The snow's covering us, we're asleep on our feet under the steel gray sky, oblivious to the rhythms of sunrise and sunset, endless as if they never began. Our teeth crack in the cold. We don't want to separate. I can barely swallow. Tell me the lyrics of your song. I want to sing with you.
Display at Christmas in a shopping mall food cart.
Court.
By James Arthur. These kids watching so intently On every side of the display must love the feeling of being gigantic, of having a giant's power over this little world of snow, where buttons lift and lower the railway's crossing gate, or switch the track, or make the bent wire topped with a toy helicopter turn and turn like a sped-up sunflower. A steam engine draws a coal tender, passenger cars, and a gleaming caboose out from the mountain tunnel, through a forest of spruce and pine, over the trestle bridge to come down near the old silver mine. Maybe all Christmases are haunted by Christmases long gone. Old songs, old customs, people who love you and who've died. Within a family, sometimes even the smallest disagreements can turn and grow unkind. The train's imaginary passengers, looking outward from inside, are steaming toward the one town they could be going to, the town they have just left, where everything is local and nothing is to scale. One church, one skating rink, one place to buy a saw, a single hook and ladder truck, and one officer of the law. Maybe in another valley it's early spring, and the thick air is redolent of chimney smoke and rain, but here the diner's always open, so you can always get a meal, or go down to the drive-in looking for a fight, or stay up all night, so tormented by desire you can hardly think. Beyond the edges of the model train display, the food court is abuzz. Gingerbread and candy canes surround a blow-mold Virgin Mary illuminated from within. A grapevine reindeer has been hung with sticks of cinnamon. One by one, kids get pulled away from the model trains. Christmas Eve is bearing down, and many chores remain undone. But for every child who leaves, another child appears. The great pagan pine catches and throws back wave on wave of light like a king-sized chandelier, announcing that the jingle hop has begun, and the drummer boy still has nothing to offer the Son of God but the sound of one small drum.
Thank you. Winter Time by Robert Louis Stevenson. Late lies a wintry sun abed, a frosty, fiery, sleepy head. Blinks but an hour or two, and then a blood-red orange sets again. Before the stars have left the skies, a morning in the dark I rise. I'm shivering in my nakedness by the cold candle, bathe and dress. Close by the jolly fire I sit to warm my frozen bones a bit, or with a reindeer sled explore the colder countries round the door. When to go out, my nurse doth wrap me in my comforter and cat. The cold wind burns my face and blows its frosty pepper up my nose. Black are my steps on silver sod, thick blows my frosty breath abroad, and tree and house and hill and lake are frosted like a wedding cake.
Thank you. No, Jack said. Good King Wenceslas. I'll count three. One, two, three. And we began to sing. Our voices high and seemingly distant in the snow-felted darkness round the house that was occupied by nobody we knew. We stood close together near the dark door. Good King Wenceslas looked out on the Feast of Stephen. And then a small, dry voice, like the voice of someone who has not spoken for a long time, joined our singing. A small, dry, eggshell voice from the other side of the door. A small, dry voice through the keyhole. And when we stopped running, we were outside our house. The front room was lovely. Balloons floated under the hot water bottle gulping gas. Everything was good again and shone over the town. Perhaps it was a ghost, Jim said. Perhaps it was trolls, Dan said, who was always reading. Let's go in and see if there's any jelly left, Jack said. And we did that. Always on Christmas night, there was music. An uncle played the fiddle. A cousin sang Cherry Ripe. And another uncle sang Drake's Drum. It was very warm in the little house. Auntie Hannah, who had gone on to the parsnip wine, sang a song about bleeding hearts and death, and then another in which she said her heart was like a bird's nest. And then everybody laughed again, and then I went to bed. Looking through my bedroom window out into the moonlight and the unending smoke-colored snow, I could see the lights in the windows of all the other houses on our hill and hear the music rising from them up the long, steady falling night. I turned the gas down, I got into bed, I said some words to the close and holy darkness, and then I slept. by Dr. Seuss.
So he paused, and the Grinch put a hand to his ear, and he did hear a sound rising over the snow. It started in low, then it started to grow. But this sound wasn't sad. Why, this sound sounded merry. It couldn't be so. But it was merry, very. He stared down at Whoville. The Grinch popped his eyes, then he shook. What he saw was a shocking surprise. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came. Somehow or other, it came just the same. And the Grinch, with his Grinch feet, ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags. And he stood and he puzzled 3 hours till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more.